Welcome back. The BlackBerry Bold 9900 has been teasing the Philippines since July this year, but the long wait is over. The thinnest BB smartphone is now in the country, and here to tell us more about this product is Mark Macanas of Tech Pinas. Mark, morning.
Yes, good morning.
All right, I am tripping all over myself because I am excited to talk about this great, it's not entirely new, but new here in the Philippines.
Yes, it's very new.
The BlackBerry 9900. Let's get started. I mean, everybody is talking about how sleek this phone is. This is the thinnest one that BlackBerry has released yet.
Yes, this is 10.5 millimeters thin, so that's very, very thin. Well, first off, I want to say that RIM Cause is the best BlackBerry smartphone that they've ever released.
Right.
So it's best in, for me, in two ways. It's best in design.
Yeah.
Because as you can see, it's, you know, around the bezel, you have stainless steel brushed metal.
Uh-huh.
So it's very, very sleek. It also has a very big QWERTY keyboard here. But another thing that really makes this amazing for me is the software.
Right.
It's the OS.
It's the OS. Okay, this is this, I believe it's OS version 7, is it?
Yes, yes.
OS 7 of BlackBerry. And people are saying that it really does provide such an enhanced surfing experience or phone use experience. What are the changes that have made it so such a wowzer for you?
Well, for one, the BlackBerry 7 OS is really optimized for touch gestures.
Right.
And it's really sleek. The user interface is really, really smooth. It's really cool. Well, you have to see this one in the flesh to really appreciate it.
I know.
But the thing that will really wow you most about the BlackBerry 7 OS is the browser.
Mm-hmm.
It's just super fast. For me, it's the fastest browser that any BlackBerry smartphone has ever had. So, again, it's something that you need to try.
The stumbling block for me for many smartphones, BlackBerry included, is what media player to use. What are you using? What do you think works best with this particular platform?
Well, actually, it supports a lot of formats for playing. Supports MP3, MP4, practically anything that's standard right now.
Right, right.
You can play with this phone.
Mm-hmm.
So it actually takes great photos and great videos.
All
for
right.
For photos, you have 5-megapixel photos.
Okay.
And you also have the autofocus. You also have the camera with the LED flash.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have the HD video capture, 720p. Yes, yes.
Okay, super.
And that will, you know, as soon as you take the video or the photo, you can view it instantly on the phone.
Yeah, now jumping back, let me get my dirty paws on this. I mean, you were saying that the design really has been the standout feature, and I agree. I mean, I love the brushed
stainless steel
finish that you've got here. It's very James Bond. I love it. It looks really great.
Very rock star.
Yeah, and you've got a little bit of this carbon fiber thing going on in the back.
Yeah.
How's the battery life been for you? What's your experience with that?
Well, battery life is, for me, it's really amazing because this one can stay connected via Wi-Fi network the whole day.
Mm-hmm.
So for me, that's enough because, you know, what you need from a smartphone is for it to have enough juice for you to go through the day.
Yeah.
And that's the most important thing.
And trust me, if you have the capability to surf, you're going to be surfing. You're going to be online. If you can be online, you're going to be online, right?
Yeah, so if it's going to stay the whole day on Wi-Fi, that's good.
And it's worked for you so far. I mean,
you can have
it running the whole day.
The whole day, yeah.
All right. Any other standout features that you find on the 9900 that sort of is a new feature that you haven't seen on some of the other BlackBerry products?
Well, it's not actually a new feature, but I bet a lot of BlackBerry fans, you know, love BlackBerry. Facebook for BlackBerry, Twitter for BlackBerry, BBM. What's nice about this phone is that all of those applications have just become better with this one.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a lot smoother. You have the 2.8-inch capacitive touchscreen that you can use to browse Facebook, to browse Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
It's really amazing.
Okay.
Again, you have to try it.
Okay.
I'm urging everyone to just try it.
I might just take this one that you have over here and try it. But there's always the big question, touchscreen or buttons? And I mean, this is really sort of combined both.
Yes.
Do you find yourself using as much of the touchscreen as you thought you would? Or the fact is, many people who are, you know, BlackBerry fans are there because they love the QWERTY keyboard, and when they first got it, and then have just really become entrenched in the system that has become BlackBerry. Is there much need for the touchscreen, considering BlackBerry has always been known as, you know, it's the smartphone with a QWERTY keypad?
Mm-hmm. For one, BlackBerry Bold 9900, that's the widest, I think, of widest QWERTY keyboard of all BlackBerry phones ever released. But it, you know, the addition of the touch
even
screen,
clumsy thumbs like mine can,
yeah,
can
even
work this.
The biggest thumbs I think won't have any problems, you know, typing on that. But it's the touchscreen is a nice addition to it because you know it adds to the experience. It makes it a lot easier to navigate web pages,
right?
To choose applications, you know, to check Facebook, Twitter, browse through photos.
Then why not just have a touchscreen to begin with? Do you think RIM is being hard-headed and really sticking to its guns with you know we've got a QWERTY keyboard and we're keeping that QWERTY keyboard?
Well, when you have a QWERTY keyboard this good, you'd want to have it on the phone.
Right.
that's what I think. I think is you know the idea behind this design because
I mean it's really polarizing. I mean either you're a BlackBerry fan or no, I like everything else. I mean BlackBerry's here and everything else is on the other side. You yourself say, I mean you're not just testing this for kicks. I mean this is a phone that you use. This is your phone.
Yeah.
Why is it that you've stuck? What is it about BlackBerry that's made you stick with it for?
Well, first of all, it's the design of the BlackBerry smartphones. When for me, the BlackBerry smartphones, you know, have probably the best design, along with you know other brands, because other brands also have their really amazing designs. But BlackBerry can really hold its own against really the best design smartphones out there, especially Bold 9900.
Right,
it really looks good, and of course, I love the social features. That's really something that I always look for, like Facebook for BlackBerry, Twitter for BlackBerry, BBM.
BBM is always you know, a big seller.
If you started as a BlackBerry user a long time ago, these are things you just can't live without.
And it sticks with you, and you become a loyal user, and you appreciate the upgrades that RIM brings. And one other feature that sort of stood out to me is the near field communication, the sort of the NFC, where you can sort of how would you call it? Tune in to other related products that you've got. Have you found that feature useful?
Actually, NFC is all about tap. Mm-hmm. You just tap and you're connected. Tap connected. Tap connected. So you know.
So this is connectivity between things like speakers, other BlackBerry
gadgets, or
devices.
You know, those with NFC chips in them.
Like the Playbook. I assume the Playbook is
the NFC Playbook. You can connect via Bluetooth.
Okay.
Then you can use actually. Wait, let me show you that. This is the BlackBerry Playbook, and it's really one of the gadgets from RIM that I really love.
That you really love. It'll work well with something.
Yes, you can actually connect your BlackBerry Bold 9900 with the BlackBerry Playbook via BlackBerry Bridge.
Okay.
Basically, you just need to connect them via Bluetooth. Then you just turn on BlackBerry Bridge. Then voila, you're connected. It's really super fast.
That's a BlackBerry feature. That's not necessarily how would you call it? A special feature of the 9900 alone. I mean that's BlackBerry to BlackBerry.
Yes, you can actually connect the BlackBerry Playbook with other BlackBerry,
stuff. Yeah. All right, very cool. All right, people are going to be asking the final question that people are going to be asking is how much? Where do we get one?
Well, without contract, it's going to cost you 31,690.
Okay.
So it's you know it's really premium phone.
Is it worth the money? Is it worth the money? I mean, considering what you can get for the same price range.
Well, considering the design and the enhancements in the BlackBerry OS, and of course the prestige, you know the celebrities have it. You know the image of BlackBerry in the Philippines. You know it's really for the high end market.
Right.
Especially the Bold line, because they also have the curved line for those who are who just wanna. The entry-level users who want to
get started on the BlackBerry adventure.
Yeah, and we also have some amazing BlackBerry Curve models coming out.
All right, but if you want the best of the best, the 9900 is the one to get.
And if you're going to ask me if it's worth the money, yes, it is for me. The design in itself is really amazing. It's like, I call it, you know, I say this a lot, I tweet this a lot. It looks like a jewel.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, well, we know that you are one big BB fan. Okay, well, thank you so much for sharing that. Mark Macanas from Tech Pinas.
Thank you. Thank you for having me over.
All right, up next, folks, the war in Afghanistan has spilled over to the microblogging site Twitter. Find out how that happened and what exactly happened when we return. This is Mornings at ANC.
Romeo sasali sa mga drawing contest yan. Lahat ng sinalihan niya, nanalo. Kasi nga, gusto niya ma-i-uplift yung buhay namin. Nakikita niya kasi ang hirap namin. Noong December 21, bumaba lang siya ng hagdan. Humihingal na siya. Sabi niya, ba't ganun? Yung diagnose sa kanya, lymphoma. Matake, terminal. Gusto kong maalala si Romeo. bilang artist kasi yung art niya hanggang ngayon talagang buhay eh.
Information. Lawmakers gave the green light to the budget bill that is worth 1.816 trillion pesos. Find out what areas could be affected by the storm.
And let's now talk to Pagasa weather forecaster.
The prime details.
Some people are stranded in different ports in the country.
All is well between President Aquino and his political advisor.
Filipino Americans are joining the Occupy Wall Street movement.
Malacanang has a bit of advice for the Supreme Court after the tribunal's recall of its decision on the FASEB case.
And the prime news of the day.
Demonstrators are setting up camp in Jersey City, New Jersey.
Weather Bureau Pagasa warned residents in the Visayas and Mindanao
a conspiracy to defraud the people and violate the law.
The biggest events deserve to be on Primetime News. Primetime on ANC. Weeknights, 8 in the evening on ANC. The ABS-CBN News.